I was born to help. I'm the last person to hurt your child. Just know that from my heart. Deal with it how you gonna deal with it from there. Hate me, can never speak to me a day from this. But every one of them, but both families will tell you, I looked at them eye to eye, man to man, and told them straight up, no. Violence? Hell no.
In today's video, we're taking a break from the NBA, and we're talking about one of the biggest mysteries in NFL history. This video was super, super tough for me to make because I'm a diehard Baltimore Ravens fan. Ray Lewis is my favorite athlete of all time. He's the reason I love the Ravens. So this video is like, it was so tough for me to make, but the story must be told. Stay tuned, Jay.
I wanna go far, there's no stopping. I see them watching, I see them waiting. One day I swear I'ma be on the station. Mama, I gotta make moves.
This is one of the biggest mysteries maybe in sports history. Nobody except for Ray Lewis and the people that actually saw everything that night truly knows what happened. So for that reason, I will only specifically detail the facts and the aftermath of what happened that night. Ray Lewis is one of the greatest football players of all time. What he's achieved in his career, only one can dream of. Two-time Super Bowl champion, Super Bowl MVP, 13-time Pro Bowler, two-time NFL Defensive Player of the Year. He's been a role model both on and off the field with his motivational speeches to basically do whatever you want in life by grinding it out with everything you have. Hell, he's the reason I even like football. I've been a Baltimore Ravens fan for as long as I can remember because of Ray Lewis. But on the night of January 30th, 2000, all of these wonderful achievements was almost cut way too short. On January 30th, 2000, Ray Lewis and about 10 friends, including Joseph Sweeting and Reginald Oakley, went to a Super Bowl party held at an Atlanta club. This was Super Bowl 34 that featured the Tennessee Titans versus the St. Louis Rams. This was the Super Bowl before Ray Lewis won his first. But allegedly around 3:30 that night, Ray Lewis and his friends headed outside to his rented limo where Oakley began to get aggressive with two other club goers. Reginald Oakley kept going at it with the guys and he got whacked on the side of his head with a champagne bottle. Then Ray Lewis would later testify, all hell broke loose at that point. Allegedly, everyone was throwing fists, everyone was throwing punches. Everyone that is, except for Ray Lewis. Ray Lewis would basically testify that while all of this was going on, he calmly rested against his limo as he watched his friends engage in the brawl. Essentially, two of the men that Ray Lewis group was fighting with, Richard Loyler and Jason Baker, was stabbed to death, while the Ray Lewis group jumped back into the limo and sped off with at least one member of the Lawyer Baker group firing a gun at the limo. What happened after the fact was pretty much bad for Ray Lewis. There was a testimony about clothing being put into a bag and thrown in a dumpster. And the biggest mystery of it all, the suit Ray Lewis wore on the night of the murders were never recovered. And when first questioned by the police, Ray Lewis told several lies about several facts. And there was a testimony that at trial, Ray Lewis told people to keep quiet and not to cooperate with the investigation. But Ray Lewis was charged for murder, basically for being a party to the murders, even though he didn't personally kill anyone. Based on the evidence, the state basically had a plan for Ray Lewis. They hoped that by threatening a star athlete with a murder charge that will ruin his career, he would turn his friends in and basically rat on them. And that's exactly what happened. In exchange for a guilty plea to lesser charges, Lewis took a stand and testified against his two friends. But in a crazy twist, both Sweeting and Oakley, the two guys that actually stabbed those other two guys, were acquitted of the murder. Basically, the jury accepted that the killings had been self-defense. So ironically, the only person who did any jail time was Ray Lewis. And that was when he was first arrested and bailed out on a $1 million bond. So to sum up what happened in court, in return for having his murder and assault charges dropped, Ray Lewis agreed to testify against his two friends and basically rat him out. And the crazy part about it, his friends didn't even do jail time because it was looked at as self-defense. Meanwhile, Ray Lewis had 1 year probation and the NFL fined him $250,000 at the start of the 2000 season. And Ray Lewis' career never really took a hit. He even said, "Jesus Christ couldn't please everybody. That's my attitude," and remaining defiant, the real truth is that this was never about those two kids laying dead in the street. This was about Ray Lewis. Don't be mad because I was on center stage. And to this day, Ray Lewis still claims his innocence, and this case still leaves a lot of people furious. The fact is that two guys died, and really no one suffered severe consequences. And all these years later, Ray Lewis holds no regrets about what happened that night in Atlanta. He says, "If I had to go through all of that over again, I wouldn't change a thing. The end result is who I am now." That's the video though, guys. If you enjoyed, make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. Tell me your opinion. Do you think he did it? Do you think he should have been jailed? Do you think it should have been more consequences to Ray Lewis? What do you think about it? Me personally, I hate to believe that he did it because, like I said, he's my favorite athlete of all time. He's the reason I like football and the Ravens. But, you know, it's just a very sad situation, tragic story, crazy story. But it must be told, like I said before this video started. If you like the video, make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. Turn on my notifications. This isn't just an NBA channel. I talk more NBA right now because it's March going on to April, so the NBA is popping. But I'm talking to NFL as well. Don't get it twisted. I like the NFL too. But if you like this video, like, comment, subscribe. If you like the channel, subscribe, do all that great stuff. And until next time, guys, stay tall. JJ.
Call your friend, let's get drunk. Call your friend, let's get drunk.
Call your friend, let's get drunk. Call your friend, let's get drunk.
12 more hours left for us in the